Theoretical and actual combustion processes. Complete combustion. If all the carbon in the fuel burns to carbon dioxide, all the hydrogen burns to water, and all the sulfur burns to sulfur dioxide. We call it as incomplete combustion if the combustion products contain any unburned fuel or components such as carbon, hydrogen, carbon monoxide, or oxides of hydrogen. Reasons for incomplete combustion can be insufficient oxygen, insufficient mixing in the combustion chamber during the limited time that the fuel and the oxygen are in contact, dissociation may be at high temperatures. Oxygen has a much greater tendency to combine with hydrogen than it does with carbon. Therefore, the hydrogen in the fuel normally burns to completion, forming water. Stoichiometric or theoretical air. The minimum amount of air needed for the complete combustion of a fuel. Also referred to as the chemically correct amount of air or 100% theoretical air. Stoichiometric or theoretical combustion. The ideal combustion process during which a fuel is burnt completely with theoretical air. Excess air. The amount of air in excess of this stoichiometric amount, usually expressed in terms of the stoichiometric air as percent excess air or percent theoretical air. Deficiency of air. Amount of air less than the stoichiometric amount, often expressed as percent deficiency of air. Equivalence ratio. The ratio of the actual fuel air ratio to the stoichiometric fuel air ratio. 50% excess air, which can be equal to 150% theoretical air, 200% excess air can be equal to 300% theoretical air, 90% theoretical air, which is equal to 10% deficiency of air. The complete combustion process with no free oxygen in the products is called theoretical combustion.